By all accounts, this was a successful visit with the Queen over the past 48 hours. The President tweeting this as we approach the 75th anniversary of D-Day. We proudly commemorate those heroic and honorable patriots who gave their all for the cause of freedom during some of history's darkest hours. Hashtag D-Day 75. Now, Gardiner, director of the Margaret Thatcher Center, Freedom and the Heritage Foundation. How you doing, Nile? Nice to have you back.
Fine, thanks, Bill. Great to be here.
What is the state of our special relationship now, do you believe?
Well, I think it's very good, actually. And today's tremendous ceremony in Portsmouth, just south of London, is a reminder of the enduring strength of the special relationship and also the tremendous sacrifice made by U.S. and British servicemen and Canadian servicemen and Commonwealth servicemen as well in the defense of freedom. And Europe owes a huge debt of gratitude to the United States and Great Britain in particular for their freedom today. And the special relationship between Great Britain and the United States has endured for several decades since World War II. It has been the beating heart of the free world in many respects, and it is very strong today. I think it could be even stronger with a new British Prime Minister coming in at the end of July. After all, there have been some differences between Theresa May and Donald Trump, but I think with a new Brexiteer Prime Minister coming in, I can expect an even stronger and more robust special relationship in place.
Now, 1.5 million Americans were gathered in the southern fields of England when the D-Day launch began, and so many more Brits as well. I think as an American, one thing that strikes me when I visited Normandy is the British War Museums that are set up there. You know, that's one thing that some of our history books I would suggest here on this side of the Atlantic does not emphasize enough. But this was a shared military partnership. And without the help of you and the help of us, it would not have been the success as it turned out to be. With regard to the current trip, I'm just looking at some of the headlines from the British tabloids and some of the major newspapers there. They were flattering in their praise for the President and the Queen. What explains that, Nile, despite some of the protests that were in central London this week?
Yeah, I think actually overall the state visit was a great success. I think this has been one of the best overseas trips for President Trump, if not the best, actually. And I think the meetings with the Queen, the royal family were absolutely tremendous. I think you have a U.S. president who is very pro-British. He is someone who has a deep affection for the British monarchy, for the royal family, for the British people, and that was demonstrated tremendously this week. There were some protests on the streets of London, quite small, a few thousand protesters actually, but I think the president was unfazed by those protests, and this was also, I think, in terms of policy, a very, very important visit as well, where President Trump advanced a clear agenda for moving forward on U.S.-U.K. relations, especially with regard to a trade deal. And I think that overall, President Trump projected strong U.S. leadership. He emphasized the tremendous strength of the special relationship. I think it was a very, very good visit overall.
Nile, nice to get your thoughts on that. Nile Gardiner, the president now, heads back to London. Then he goes to Ireland for the overnight. We'll see him in Normandy tomorrow morning this time. Thank you, sir. Nile Gardiner.
Thank you.
In London.